Sri Gurubhyo Nama Children, welcome to online session. We are going to start with surface chemistry today. What is surface chemistry? That is the phenomenon that is taking place at the surface. Instead of accumulation of substances in the bulk, we are going to talk about the accumulation of the substance at the surface. We are going to talk about the concentration, higher concentration or accumulation of a particular substance at the surface. So there may be difference in finding out the accumulation at the surface as well as in the bulk. So we are going to talk about here only the accumulation of a substance at the surface or higher concentration of the substance at the surface. We can call this chemistry as surface chemistry. Surface phenomenon, the phenomenon that is occurring at the surface, the study of the particular reaction at the surface, the accumulation or concentration of a particular substance at the surface, we can call it as surface chemistry. So we are going to talk about surface chemistry here. All the reactions what we are going to see is related to surface phenomenon. Instead of talking about the accumulation in the bulk, we are going to talk about the accumulation of the substance only at the surface. So we are going to talk about reactions that is taking place at the surface. Particularly, I wanted to introduce an important concept here, that is adsorption. We are going to talk about adsorption and absorption. What is adsorption and what is absorption? What are the factors that affect adsorption? And what are the various concepts that are related to adsorption? Everything we are going to see in detail. So this lesson talks about the phenomenon that is taking place at the surface. So are you ready, children? I am going to go inside the lesson now. Be ready now. Each and every page there are concepts. I want everybody to be attentive so that you can get clarity in the concepts as well as you can get very good marks. So I am going to proceed, children. This is actually surface chemistry. So we are going to talk about surface chemistry today. And already this picture talks about the phenomenon that is taking place at the surface. So this picture talks about the phenomenon that we are going to discuss at the surface. So this is surface chemistry. The next one, there is a definition for surface chemistry. I am going to define the surface chemistry. The branch of chemistry, it is a branch of chemistry which deals with the nature of surfaces and the phenomenon that occur at the surface. So what is surface chemistry? It is a branch that deals with the nature of the surface. We are going to talk about the phenomenon which completely covers the nature of the surface. We have to, because all these phenomena are occurring at the surface. So the surface chemistry deals with the phenomenon that talks about the nature of the surface and the phenomenon that occur at the surface. We are going to talk about the nature of the surface and we are going to talk about the reactions, or we are going to talk about the process, or we are going to talk about the phenomenon that occurs at the surface or interface. We can call it as surface chemistry. The phenomenon that occurs at the surface or the reactions that are taking place at the surface, we can call it as surface chemistry. So surface chemistry is nothing but the phenomenon reactions taking place at the surface. So we are going to talk about the surface phenomenon. So So I defined surface chemistry, it is nothing but a branch of chemistry that deals with the, what is that, nature of the surface. We are going to discuss about the nature of the surface, and we are going to discuss about the reactions or the phenomenon that is occurring at the surface. So we can call it as surface chemistry. The next page, very very important term related to surface chemistry. The phenomenon or the concept that is related to surface chemistry, we can call it as adsorption. Term related to, term related to surface chemistry. So what is actually, this slide completely gives the definition for adsorption. So here we are going to discuss the process called adsorption. Adsorption, what is adsorption? Accumulation, accumulation of the substance at the surface. So already I have told in the first slide, surface chemistry is nothing but the chemistry that deals, the phenomenon that deals with the surface, the reactions that are taking place at the surface. So we are going to consider the nature of the surface also, because we are going to talk about the concentration or accumulation of a substance at the surface. So when the phenomenon is related to the surface, we have a concept called adsorption. So adsorption is related to the surface. It is a surface phenomenon. So one of the important terms related to surface chemistry. What is adsorption, or define adsorption? What is that actually? The phenomenon of attracting and retaining the molecules at the surface of a solid or a liquid. So what we are doing actually, what is this definition, what it tells us? It is nothing but the phenomenon of attracting or retaining the molecules at the surface of a solid or a liquid. What we are going to do? What we are going to do actually? What is adsorption? What is the definition for adsorption? It is a phenomenon where we are going to retain, or we are going to attract the molecules at the surface of a solid or a liquid. So we are going to see the accumulation of a particular substance at the surface of a solid or at the surface of a liquid. So here, when you talk about this, so what is that actually? Attracting and retaining the molecules at the surface of a solid or a liquid. So here what we are doing actually, this phenomenon is related to the surface. We are studying the phenomenon that is occurring at the surface. So we have to talk about, we have to talk about the concentration, we have to talk about the accumulation, we have to talk about the concentration of the substance at the surface. So it is not, adsorption is nothing but the phenomenon of attracting and retaining the molecules. So what we are going to do? We are going to attract, or it is retained, the molecules are retained at the surface of a solid or liquid. So the substance that gets attracted or accumulated at the surface of a solid or liquid, so we can call it as adsorption. So here what you will say, at the surface we can see the higher concentration, higher concentration of the molecules on the surface, as it is a surface phenomenon. We are talking about surface chemistry. So we are talking about the accumulation of the substance, concentration of the particles at the surface than in the bulk. So definitely there is a difference between the accumulation of substance at the surface than in the bulk. So as we are discussing about the, what is that, adsorption phenomenon that is related to the surface, we are going to see the higher concentration of a particular substance at the surface. So we can call such a term as adsorption. So already I told about adsorption, it is a, so what is that, related to the surface chemistry. The term related to surface chemistry, I defined adsorption. What is adsorption? What is the definition for for absorption, actually the phenomenon of attracting and retaining the molecules. So it is a phenomenon, actually the molecules are attracted or retained at the surface of a solid or a gas. So it can be a solid or a liquid. So these molecules we can see which are retained at the surface of a solid or a liquid. So usually when you compare the concentration at the surface than in the bulk, definitely there is a difference. As it is a surface phenomenon, we can see a higher concentration of a particular substance at the surface than in the bulk. So there is a difference between the concentration of a substance at the surface than in the bulk. As it is a surface chemistry, as we are dealing with surface chemistry, we can see the higher concentration of a particular substance at the surface than in the bulk. So we can call it as adsorption. So the concept is very clear that this is one of the important term that is related to surface chemistry. The next one we are going to see, first I defined adsorption. I told that the accumulation of a particular substance or the attraction of a particular substance at the surface, as we are discussing the, what is that, surface chemistry, which is a surface phenomenon. So there is a concept related to surface chemistry, I defined adsorption. The higher concentration we have seen of a particular substance at the surface than in the bulk, so I defined as adsorption. So definitely I saw difference of the concentration at the surface than in the bulk. I saw higher concentration of a substance, particular substance, at the surface than in the bulk, so I have defined this term as adsorption. Now we are going to say terms related to adsorption. We are going to talk about the terms related to adsorption. So there are two different terms related to adsorption. One is adsorbent, another one is adsorbate. If the phenomenon of adsorption has to take place, I need two important terms that are related to adsorption. One is adsorbent, another one is adsorbate. So there are two different terms that are related to adsorption. What are they? One is adsorbent, another one is adsorbate. Now we are going to see what is adsorbent and what is adsorbate, how these two concepts are playing a greater role in the, what is that, in the phenomenon of adsorption. Why do we need these two, what is that, terms in order to, what is that, conduct adsorption process? So we are going to see in detail now. So this slide completely talks about the terms related to adsorption. There are two different terms related to adsorption, very very important terms related to adsorption. One is adsorbent, another one is adsorbate. Adsorbent and adsorbate. I am going to define adsorbent. So what is adsorbent? The solid substance on the surface of which adsorption occurs. So how will be the adsorbent? What is the nature of the adsorbent? Usually the adsorbent should be solids. So what type of substance we can take as an adsorbent? So here actually usually we will take adsorbents in the form of a solid. So what is adsorbent? Actually the solid substance on the surface, we are taking the solids on the surface of which adsorption occurs. So what is an adsorbent? So adsorbent, it is very specific. So we are going to take a solid substance on which surface the phenomena of adsorption takes place. So adsorbent is the first term which is related to adsorption. So what is adsorbent? Actually we are going to take solid substances that are acting as adsorbents. So these solid substances, only at the surface of these solid substances we can see the process of adsorption. So the solid substance on the surface of which adsorption occurs, on the surface of which adsorption occurs, we can call it as adsorbent. So what is an adsorbent? Very specific. So adsorbents are usually solids. So only at the surface of these solid substances, the phenomenon of adsorption occurs. So adsorbents are solid substances on the surface of which adsorption occurs. So this is the first term. One second term related to adsorption, the other one is adsorbate. What is adsorbate? The substance that get adsorbed. The substances that get adsorbed on the solid surface. The substances that get adsorbed. The substances that get adsorbed on the solid surface. We can call it as, what is it? We can call it as adsorbate. How can it be adsorbed? What is the possibility? How is it possible? What is that actually? Why adsorption is taking place? We are going to talk about the, what is that, residual attractive forces at the surface. Because of the residual attractive force due to the intermolecular attraction, or we are going to talk about the, what is that, residual attractive force that are prevailing at the surface that leads to adsorption. So we have defined two important terms that related to adsorption. What is that? Adsorbent, another one is adsorbate. What is adsorbent? How it should be? Usually we are taking solid substances as adsorbent on the surface of which the phenomenon of adsorption takes place. And what is the other term related to adsorption? Adsorbate, the substances that get adsorbed on the surface of the solid. How it is getting adsorbed? What is possible? What is the possibility there? How it is getting adsorbed? Due to the intermolecular force of attraction. So due to the intermolecular attractions, so these substances are getting adsorbed at the surface. So we can call it as adsorbate. So this slide completely talks about adsorbent and adsorbate. So what is an adsorbent? Usually adsorbent should be solids, because on the surface of which we can get the, we can talk about the phenomenon of adsorption. So usually adsorbents are solid substances on the surface of which adsorption takes place. What is an adsorbate? Adsorbate is nothing but the substances that get adsorbed. The materials are the substances that get adsorbed at the surface of the adsorbent, at the solid surface of the adsorbent. We can call it as adsorbate. How it is getting adsorbed? How these substances are getting adsorbed at the surface? What is prevailing at the surface? We are getting, there is intermolecular force of attraction. Because of the intermolecular force of attraction, adsorption is taking place. These substances are getting adsorbed at the surface. So I told you, this is adsorbate. You can see the adsorbate, that is, substances that are being adsorbed. Substances that are being adsorbed. Where are these substances? At the surface. Where are these substances? Where are these substances we can find? At the surface. So substances that gets adsorbed at the surface, we can call it as adsorbate. What is adsorbent here? Usually adsorbents will be solids on whose surface? On whose surface adsorption takes place? So I have told about two important terms that related to adsorption. What is the first one? Adsorbent. Another one is adsorbate. The picture clearly talks about adsorbent and adsorbate. What is an adsorbent? Adsorbent, usually it should be a solid where on the surface of which we can see the adsorption. So usually adsorbent should be a solid surface on the surface of which the phenomenon of adsorption is taking place. What is an adsorbate? Adsorbate is a substance that gets adsorbed at the surface of the adsorbent. So adsorbent and adsorbate, definitely very, very important. These are the two related terms that is connected to the, what is it, adsorption. So the terms related to adsorption, one is adsorbent, another one is adsorbate. So this slide completely talks about the terms that are related to adsorption. Now we are going to see the next one. See the next slide, ma. Desorption and occlusion. All these are the various terms that are related to adsorption, that are related to surface chemistry. First one I told about adsorption. That is the phenomenon that occurs at the surface. We can call it at the surface, we can call it as adsorption. And in the next slide, I told about the two different terms that are related to adsorption. One is adsorbent, another one is adsorbate. What is an adsorbent? The solid substances on the surface of which adsorption occurs, we can call it as adsorbent. What is an adsorbate? The substances that gets accumulated at the surface of the adsorbent, we can call it as adsorbate. How is it possible? How this accumulation is taking place? Because I told about the intermolecular force of attraction. Because of that, what is that? We can see the substance that gets adsorbed at the surface. Then the next slide, it talks about desorption and occlusion. Desorption and occlusion. We are going to talk about desorption and occlusion. What is desorption? Removal. What you are going to remove? The products, that is the substances that are accumulated at the surface. We are going to remove the substances that gets accumulated at the surface. We can call it as desorption. So desorption is nothing but removal. Removing or removal. So actually, this slide talks about two important terms. One is desorption, another one is occlusion. What is desorption? Removal of the adsorbed substances at the surface. When we are going to remove the substances that gets accumulated at the surface, the removal of adsorbed materials at the surface, from the process of removal of an adsorbed substance from the surface on which it is adsorbed, this is called desorption. What is desorption? Removing. What we are going to remove? We are going to remove the substances that are adsorbed at the surface of the adsorbent. Removal of the substances that are adsorbed at the surface of an adsorbent is called desorption. The process of removal of an adsorbed substance. So what we are going to do? We are going to remove the substance that gets adsorbed from the surface, on which it is adsorbed. So the removal of a particular substance from the surface on which it is adsorbed, so we can call it as desorption. So desorption is nothing but removal of a substance. So the substance that is formed or that gets accumulated at the surface is easily removed. We can call this process as desorption. And what is the other term we are going to use here? What is the other term we are going to relate here? Occlusion. What is occlusion? Phenomenon of adsorption of gases. It is very specific. So what is occlusion actually? Phenomenon of adsorption of the gases on the surface of metals. So when you talk about occlusion, it is nothing but when gases are adsorbed. So it is very specific here. What type of what is the substances are getting adsorbed at the surface? It is very particular. It is very specific here. They are talking about gases. The adsorption of gas at the surface of a solid. What is the solid we are taking here? Metals. Usually we are taking, what is that? Metals, which is in the form of solids. So here, when you talk about occlusion, the phenomenon of adsorption of gases at the surface of the metal. So usually gases are getting adsorbed at the surface of the metal. So here, what is an adsorbent? Gas is an adsorbate. Gas is an adsorbate. What is a metal? Metal is an adsorbent. So here we are talking about occlusion, where the adsorption of gases at the solid surface. What is that we are taking here? Metal. So we can see the phenomenon of adsorption of the gases at the surface of the metal. We can call it as occlusion. So this slide talks about two important terms. I told you, one is desorption, another one is occlusion. What is desorption? Removal. We are going to remove. What we are going to remove? The removal of adsorbed material. Whatever is adsorbed at the surface, we are going to remove it. Removal of adsorbed material from the surface of the solid, we can call it as desorption. What is the other one I told you? Occlusion. Occlusion is a phenomenon of adsorption of gases. So usually in occlusion, we can see the gases that gets adsorbed at the surface of a solid. What type of solids you are taking here? Usually metals. So gases, the phenomenon of adsorption of gases at the surface of the metals, we can call it as occlusion. So this slide, this picture completely talks about desorption. You see here, something is removed. Removal of adsorbed substance. See here, this picture talks about, see here, something is getting removed, is it not? Something is coming away from the surface. The material is coming away from the surface. So it is separated. The substances are getting, it gets separated from the surface. So we can call this process as the desorption. So this slide completely talked about desorption and occlusion. What is desorption? Actually, the phenomenon where we are going to remove the adsorbed material. So what is desorption? Is actually removing. What we are going to remove? The substances that get accumulated, that are accumulated at the surface. The phenomenon of removal of the substances at the surface, we can call it as, what is that? Desorption. What is occlusion? Actually, occlusion is a phenomenon where we can see the gas particles or the gas molecules that are adsorbed at the surface of a solid. Here, what type of solids we are taking? Metals. So two terms are very clear. One is desorption, another one is occlusion. The next one, I am going to talk about examples. We are going to see examples for adsorption. Actually, it is one of the, what is that, example where adsorption of a dye by charcoal. Charcoal is one of the important, what is that, one of the important substances which can act as an adsorbent. So here, what is an adsorbent here? Charcoal is an adsorbent. Here, charcoal is an adsorbent. Charcoal is an adsorbent here. What is a dye here? Dye is a adsorbate. So here, we are going to see some examples for adsorption. And what is the example they have given? Adsorption of a dye by charcoal. So there are two different materials I have taken here. One is adsorbent, another one is adsorbate, because we are discussing about adsorption. So for adsorption to occur, I need two important materials. What are they? One is adsorbent, another one is adsorbate. Here we are going to see one example, adsorption of a dye by charcoal. So here charcoal is an adsorbent. And what type of material is a dye? It is a adsorbate. So we are going to see now. When animal charcoal is shaken with a solution of organic dye, which is methylene blue. So here, what is that? Dye solution, this is methylene blue. So what is happening? When this methylene blue is shaken with, what is the charcoal? So what is the adsorbent here? Charcoal is an adsorbent and methylene blue is an adsorbate. So both are, what is that? This charcoal is adsorbing, what is that? The dye particles from the methylene blue. So what is happening? When animal charcoal is shaken with,
a solution of an organic dye. What is the organic dye solution you have taken here? Methylene blue, which is an organic dye. When this animal charcoal is shaken with a solution of an organic dye, what is happening such as methylene blue? What is happening to the solution? It becomes colorless. The solution becomes colorless. So what is that? See the particles. Dye particles. So actually this is the charcoal, is it not? This is charcoal. So what is this actually? When a dye solution is shaken with, what is that? Charcoal. So what is happening here? What is the use of this charcoal? What it does? It absorbs the particles of the dye. The dye particles are getting absorbed at its surface. Absorption has taken place. Absorption has taken place here. So what is the charcoal? What is the role of charcoal here? It is acting as an absorbent. What is the role of the methylene blue here? It is a adsorbate. Dye particles, dye particles, what is happening? When this dye solution is shaken with charcoal, what is happening? The dye particles are getting accumulated. We can see the particles of the dye which gets accumulated at the surface of the charcoal. We can see the dye particles accumulated at the surface of the charcoal. What phenomenon has taken place? Adsorption has taken place. So here you see the solution which is kept in the receiver. Next, flask? See the solution in the flask. In the first flask, the solution is colored. What is happening there? The colored, the dye particles are getting adsorbed at the surface of the charcoal. Adsorption has taken place. What happened to the solution now? The solution becomes colorless. Previously, initially, in the beginning, my solution is colored solution. Dye solution, actually all the dyes are colored in nature. That's why, what is the fabric? What we are doing? We are giving color to the fabric to in order to get the color. Not to be attractive. Is it not? So here, all the dyes are, colored solutions. So when they are shaken with charcoal, what is happening? The charcoal adsorbs the particles of the dye. So charcoal is an adsorbent here. So what is the adsorbate? What is the dye particles? So dye particles getting adsorbed at the surface of the charcoal. So see the solution, dye solution, what is happening? After adsorption, it becomes colorless. So we can call this, substance? We can quote this as an example for adsorption. The discharge of the color, is due to the adsorption of the colored components on the surface of animal charcoal. Why the solution has become colorless? What is the reason? Because previously, initially, the solution has got some colored particles. So when it is shaken with animal charcoal, what has happened? This charcoal completely adsorbs the colored materials, thereby rendering the solution colorless. So initially, my dye solution has got color. So at the end of the adsorption, what happened? As adsorption has taken place, as charcoal has completely adsorbed the colored particles in my dye solution, my final solution, my dye solution has become colorless now. So it has rendered colorless, it was found to be colorless now. Animal charcoal is used for decolorizing. So what is the adsorbent we have taken here? Animal charcoal. So it is used as an adsorbent here. It is an adsorbent. So here animal charcoal plays the role of adsorbent. So what it does? Completely it adsorbs the, dye particles on its surface. As a result, what is happening? It rendered the solution colorless. So initially my solution has got color. So because of the color materials, that is why it is appearing color. And what is happening? Adsorption is taking place here. What is that actually? Charcoal is playing the role of adsorbent. It adsorbs the colored materials on its surface. As a result, what is happening? The solution becomes colorless. So this is one of the example for, what is that, adsorption. The next one, we are going to talk about another example. Another example I am going to give for adsorption. That is, here also, listen, we are going to say aqueous solution. We are going to talk about aqueous solution of raw sugar by animal charcoal. Whenever aqua solution of raw sugar, how will be the aqua solution of raw sugar yellowish brown? How will be the aqua solution of raw sugar? How it will be? How will be the aqua solution of raw sugar? It will be yellowish brown in color. Whenever the aqua solution of raw sugar is shaken with animal charcoal, again, what is the adsorbate here? Raw sugar. Aqua solution of raw sugar is an adsorbate. What is an adsorbent here? Again, what is that we are talking about? Animal charcoal. It is an adsorbent. So again, one more example we are going to say. How aqua solution of raw sugar is becoming colorless. So what is the, again here we talk about adsorption. So aqua solution of raw sugar, it will be usually yellowish brown in color, yellowish brown. So the aqua solution of raw sugar will be yellowish brown in color. When it is shaken with animal charcoal, or when this aqueous, what is the raw sugar solution is passed over animal charcoal, what is happening? The solution becomes colorless. The solution become colorless. What is that actually? Because adsorption of sugar particles. Sugar particles are getting adsorbed at the surface of the charcoal. So sugar particles are the, what is that? Adsorbates. And what is the adsorbent here? Animal charcoal. So when aqueous solution of raw sugar, that is yellowish brown in color, when it is passed over animal charcoal, adsorption is taking place. Animal charcoal, what it does, it completely adsorbs the sugar particles present there, thereby rendering the solution colorless. The solution becomes colorless. So two examples I gave for adsorption. One is, I told about the dye solution, methylene blue. I gave an example. When organic dye solution, methylene blue I have taken. So it has shaken with animal charcoal. What has happened? All those colored materials that were there initially, it were adsorbed by the, what is that, animal charcoal, which played the role of adsorbent. Finally, what happened? The solution has become colorless. And one more example I gave, that is, what is that? We are taking the aqueous solution of raw sugar, which is yellowish brown in color. When it is passed over animal charcoal, the animal charcoal adsorbs the sugar particles, thereby rendering the solution colorless. So these are the two examples for adsorption. Now we are going to talk about adsorption and absorption. Only one letter is a difference. There's a difference of only one letter. What is that? D and B. We are going to discuss, we are going to distinguish, we are going to differentiate adsorption and absorption. What is adsorption? It is a surface phenomenon. What is an adsorption? It is a surface phenomenon. Already I told you, adsorption is a phenomenon that occurs only at the surface. So it is a surface phenomenon. What is an absorption? It is a bulk phenomenon. So, also surface phenomenon where? Only at the surface. Surface phenomenon occurring only at the surface. It is a bulk phenomenon. Occurs throughout the body. Throughout the body we can see the change. So we can call it as, what is that? Absorption. So what is the first difference? The first difference is, under adsorption, I told that it is a surface phenomenon. So occurs only at the surface. Whereas when you talk about absorption, occurs throughout the body. It is not a surface phenomenon. It occurs throughout the body. So this is the first difference. What is the second difference? The rate of adsorption is higher in the beginning. So in the beginning, how the adsorption rate, speed? How the rate of adsorption, how the speed of adsorption? How far it is efficient? So it will be greater, higher. The rate of adsorption is higher in the beginning and decrease till equilibrium. So what is the equilibrium? Once when the adsorption is completed, equilibrium is adsorption gets completed. Adsorption gets completed. So here, when you talk about the second difference, what is second difference? Under adsorption, the rate of adsorption is higher at the beginning At the beginning, the process taking place. So how the process taking place? At a faster rate. At a faster rate. So the rate of adsorption is higher in the beginning. So when the adsorption continues, so what will happen? Slowly the rate of the reaction decreases. Once when the reaction attains equilibrium, what is equilibrium? Adsorption process will be completed. Completely it will be over. The process of adsorption will be completed. Such a case, such a, what is that? We can call such a, what is the case as equilibrium. So what is an equilibrium? It is a state at which adsorption is complete. So we can call it as equilibrium. So how the rate of the reaction will be? In the beginning, we are discussing about adsorption now. I am discussing about adsorption now. So in the beginning, the rate of the reaction will be faster. The rate of adsorption will be faster. Once the reaction attains equilibrium, when it attains the balanced state, that is where the adsorption is complete, in such a case, how the rate of the reaction will be? It will be decreasing. So at the beginning, it will be greater when the reaction proceeds, and finally when it attains equilibrium, the rate of the reaction decreases. Under absorption, the rate of the absorption remains same throughout the entire process. Here there is no difference in the rate of the reaction. So when you compare the rate of the reaction in the beginning as well as at the end, it remains similar. There is no change in the rate of the reaction in the beginning as well as at the end of the reaction in case of absorption. So the rate remains same. The rate of adsorption remains same throughout the entire process, from the beginning as well as to the end. The speed of the reaction, the rate of the reaction remains, what is that, constant. It remains same. So this slide completely talks about adsorption and absorption. Adsorption and absorption. What is adsorption? Surface phenomenon. Phenomenon that occurs at the surface. What is absorption? Phenomenon that occurs in the bulk. So adsorption is at the surface, absorption is at the bulk, in the bulk. And what about the second point we have discussed? We have talked about the rate of the reaction. Under adsorption, the rate of the reaction will be faster. So the rate will be greater. The rate of the reaction will be greater at the beginning. So the reaction is taking place. Adsorption is taking place. So the rate of the reaction will be greater at the beginning. When the reaction attains equilibrium, equilibrium, that is the state where the adsorption is complete. So at the end, what is happening? The rate of the reaction decreases. Whereas in case of absorption, the rate of the reaction at the beginning as well as at the end remains same. So this is the slide that talks about the differences between adsorption and absorption. And I wanted to show the, what is the pictures related to adsorption and absorption. See here, this picture talks about adsorption. We can see the molecules. We can see the molecules that adhere at the surface of the face. We can see the molecules that are accumulated at the surface. We can see the accumulation of molecules at the surface. We can see the retention of molecules at the surface. So we can quote this for adsorption. You see here, molecules are drawn into the bulk. Molecules are drawn into the bulk. You can see the, what is that, accumulation of the particles inside, that is in the bulk. We can see the molecules that are drawn into the bulk. Here the molecules are accumulated only at the surface. So this is adsorption, this is absorption, where molecules are, the particles get accumulated only at the surface. The molecules get, what is that, retained. The molecules are retained at the surface. We can see the higher concentration of the molecules at the surface. So it is a surface phenomenon, adsorption. Here we can see the molecules inside the bulk. The molecules are drawn inside the bulk, into the bulk. The molecules are drawn into the bulk. So we are talking, this slide talks about the absorption. And we are going to talk about the types of adsorption. There are two different types of adsorption. there are two different types of adsorption, physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. First I defined adsorption, I told about the concepts related to adsorption. We have talked about desorption and occlusion. Then I told about what is that adsorption and absorption differences. I gave examples for adsorption. Now we are going to talk about the types of adsorption. There are two different types of adsorption. One is physical adsorption, another one is chemical adsorption. Already I told you. What do we need for adsorption? There are some force of attraction. Some force of attraction is there, what is it, at the surface. Because of this force of attraction, adsorption is taking place. So here, when you talk about physical adsorption, if accumulation of a gas, particularly, we are very particular now, gases on solids, what is the gas here, what is the role of a gas here, what is that we can quote, adsorbate. So, our adsorbate is in the form of a gas. What about adsorbent air, which is in the form of a solid? So here we are very, very much particular. We are talking about the, what is that? Gas particles or gaseous molecules that are retained at the surface of a solid. So what type of adsorbate we are taking? Gas. So my adsorbate is in the form of a gas. What is my adsorbent? It is in the form of a solid. Adsorption of a gas on the solid surface. So here, physical adsorption. If accumulation of a gas on the surface of a solid occurs due to weak van der Waals forces. So when the accumulation occurs, or when you see the retention of the particles at the surface, that is here we are talking about the gas. The accumulation of gaseous particles or the retention of gaseous particles or the attraction of gaseous particles at the surface. How it is attracted? Due to weak van der Waals force. When the force of attraction acting on the surface is weak van der Waals force, we can call such an adsorption as physical adsorption. Physical, weak force. So actually we are very specific. We are talking about gas on solid. So what type of adsorbate we are talking? Gases. What type of adsorbents we are taking? Solids. Usually adsorbents will be solids. Adsorbate can be a liquid or a gas. Here we are very much specific. We are talking about the adsorption of a gas on the solid. There are two different types of adsorption. One is physical adsorption, another one is chemical adsorption or chemisorption. What is physical adsorption? When there is a retention of gaseous molecule or accumulation of gaseous molecule or attraction of gaseous molecule at the surface occurs due to the weak van der Waals force. When there is accumulation of gas particles at the surface of a solid, we can call such a phenomenon as physical adsorption. So physical adsorption is nothing but the adsorption takes place at the surface due to weak van der Waals force. Here the gaseous particles are retained at the surface of the solid due to weak van der Waals force. So we can call it as physical adsorption. What is chemical adsorption? When accumulation of the gaseous molecule at the surface of the solid takes place due to strong chemical bonds. If accumulation of a gas on the surface of a solid occurs due to chemical bonds, it is called as chemical adsorption. So when you see the accumulation of gas particles at the surface of a solid due to strong chemical bond, usually chemical bonds will be strong, the attractive forces will be strong, is it not? So when there is accumulation or retention or attraction of a gaseous particle at the surface due to strong chemical bond, we can call it as chemical adsorption, or it can be called as chemisorption. So here there are two different types of adsorption I told you. One is physical adsorption, that is the retention or attraction or higher concentration of gaseous molecule at the surface of a solid due to weak van der Waals force. It is known as physical adsorption. What is chemical adsorption? If you see the accumulation or retention or attraction of a gaseous particle at the surface of a solid due to strong chemical bond, we can call it as chemical adsorption, or it can be otherwise called as chemisorption. So this slide talks about the different types of adsorption, physical and chemical adsorption.